In order to curtail the biological weapons, there was a biological weapon convention that was released, which was in the name of BWC. And this was the first multilateral disarmament treaty that was aimed to ban any kind of weapons of mass destruction. So the first important treaty was focusing only on biological weapons, no other kind of weapons. Now, what does this treaty basically focus on? It talked about banning, stockpiling the development of the biological agents or the toxins which could be used in any form except the peaceful purpose. So any kind of biological produce that is being done, if it is developed, if it is stockpiled, if it is being acquired, which is not for peaceful purpose, that would be under the biological weapon convention. Also, if it is used for hostile purpose or for any conflict that could be generated, or if it is being transferred from one nation to another nation for assistance or for use in another nation, that would be falling under the treaty. If we talk about the BWC, which is the Biological Weapon Convention, it was initially started in 1972. However, it was finally into force in 1975. And as of now, we have nearly 183 nations who have ratified this treaty. What is signatory and what is ratification of a treaty, we would be understanding in a separate class. But the sole idea is, signatories are those nations which agree to be part of that concept, and ratification is if they try to implement it on their own domestic level within their parliaments or within their constitutional or parliamentary setup, that is considered as ratification. So we have 183 nations who have already ratified it. Now, this treaty does not talk about or does not ban bio defense programs, if any. So very important, it is banning only and only in case the biological things are being used as weapons. So this world map talks about the nations which have already signed and ratified it. Those who have acceded to it or succeeded to it means once the treaty was already done, there could be no scope for any further negotiations, and whatever has been laid down in the treaty has to be now accepted by the parties who would join it later. There are some nations who have simply signed it, and there are some nations who are yet to sign it, who are not yet part of it in the region of Africa, as you could see. The idea is, the prior to the Biological Weapon Convention, there was a convention on the prohibition, development, production and stockpiling of bacteriological and toxic weapons and their destruction. And this was the prior name of Biological Weapons Convention that was released. And this is a kind of relatively short convention that is there with just 15 important articles. And here we have the major summary of articles. So, 6 or 7 of those articles are really important. First article talks about prohibiting any kind of biological weapon. The next talks about, article 3 talks about prohibiting the transfer of these biological weapons. The article 4 talks about a national wide implementation of the programs to understand and manage this. Article 5 talks about the cooperation among the member nations and a proper consultation to be established. Article 6 talks about any complaints about the violation of this convention. Article 7 talks about assistance once the violation has been done, and Article 10 talks about the peaceful cooperation. So these are some of the major articles. If you want to go into the detail, we have the list of the 10 articles and the details that have been laid down. In 2019, we have Tanzania that became a party to this convention. In 2018, we had Palestine and New that joined this convention. There are 3 important depositories. Depositories are those nations which are basically interested to maintain this treaty. And the 3 nations are UK, USA and Russia. So those are the 3 nations that are depository to this treaty. And under this treaty, we do have certain confidence building measures. What do we mean by confidence building measures? Confidence building measures are the measures that maintain transparency. What does that mean? There would be a declaration on part of the nation that we have nothing to declare or we have nothing new to declare. If there have been certain new data centers that have been developed, those would be informed at the BWC. If there is any information that is being obtained, exchange of information becomes part to it. If there are certain infectious diseases that are seen in the nation, if there is outbreak of any infectious disease, exchange of information on those would be immediately provided. People or governments would be encouraged to publish the researches in the field of biological developments which are related with an objective of providing knowledge to the fellow nations. Would be encouraged. So these are certain confidence building measures, and any past activities would be taken into light for the future development. So as per the confidence building measures, we have seen that 61 states actually explained what had been part of their changes in the protocol, or they had something to declare, they did not had anything new to declare, whatsoever the case was. However, we have seen in 2013 this proportion declined significantly, and from the 61 nations, it was only 47 nations that finally talked about the confidence building measures. So despite the fact that these nations are part of the BWC, the Biological Weapon Conventions, they are not ready to have the declaration for the confidence building measures in future. And this could be highly detrimental. Every 5 years, the convention actually meets and the membership is for an unlimited duration. But these confidence building measures definitely need to be reinforced. If we try to summarize these confidence building measures, they are in the category of A to G. G talks about the vaccination production facility, which is very, very important as part of the confidence building measures. F talks about the past activities in the biological research that have been done. C talks about the research results that should be promoted. And B talks about the outbreak of any kind of infectious diseases that have occurred or has been occurring in the region. So those are some of the important things that you need to know about Biological Weapons Convention, a very, very important topic this time. But we do have certain challenges with this convention that is there. The first important challenge is the misuse of the scientific developments that we have witnessed. The fact that the scientific developments have seen a significant improvement, there have been technological developments that have been there, but despite of that, we have witnessed a significant misuse, and also there have been technological challenges that have basically led us in a position where we are unable to verify the weapons, how vast they could be or how vast their impact could be, and also the financial crunch that is being faced by many of the developing nations. So those are certain challenges that we have witnessed with this convention, and moreover similar challenges have been seen with other conventions as well, which we have discussed in our separate class 30 important environmental conventions. Stay tuned for many more updates from our side. Have a wonderful day ahead.